Hi everybody, I'm Shelby at the Agnes Robinson Waterloo Public Library, and welcome to our first book talk of 2021. Happy New Year! We took a little break from these book talks because in December, the publishing industry for books was really slow. They weren't churning out many reads, so we didn't have a lot of new things coming into the library. But it's a new year, lots of amazing books are being published in 2021, and I'm so excited to share five of them with you today. So stay tuned, I hope you find something interesting to add to your reading pile, and maybe you'll find a new author that will spice things up. One quick note about these books today is that they all have a common theme, and I did not plan this, publishers did not plan this, but they all have to do with the American South. They either take place down South or are related to the South in some way, so that's kind of a fun pattern to find in these recommendations. So we can read about a place that maybe we've never lived in or never visited. My first recommendation is The Prophets by Robert Jones Jr. I'm so excited to read this one. This debut novel is about a forbidden relationship between two enslaved young men, Isaiah and Samuel, on a plantation in the Deep South. The peace and refuge they find in one another is threatened when a fellow elder slave kind of shakes things up and starts preaching the master's gospel on the plantation to his fellow enslaved people. So Isaiah and Samuel's love is now seen as sinful and is in clear danger to the plantation's harmony. So if you want to read more historical fiction, this book sounds like it is about betrayal and love and loss. And I think it'd be perfect if you are a fan of Toni Morrison, Colson Whitehead, or Yah Jesse. That's The Prophets by Robert Jones Jr. My next pick is 20 by thriller writer James Grippendoe. It's also a little heavy, so sorry. But this book is about what every parent and child fears the most, and that is learning that there is an active shooter on campus or at school. This book takes place in Florida, so going with our southern theme, where a school shooting marks the fifth mass shooting in the state in 5 years. Lawyer Jack Switek is at his office when he receives the emergency message from his daughter's school. And I don't want to tell you who claims responsibility for the shooting and the drama that ensues, but Jack's family is caught in the crossfire of this legal thriller. He's a lawyer, so of course his profession gets involved with the drama. And I think this book would be perfect for fans of John Grisham and Michael Connelly. So that is 20 by James Grippendoe. Next up is a work of nonfiction that was actually published back in June, but is new to our library and is ever relevant. It is Our Time Is Now by Stacey Abrams. We are wrapping up a very contentious election year, and a lot is being said about voting rights and voter fraud. Stacey Abrams is an expert when it comes to voting. She's a lawyer, a voter advocate, a former congresswoman, and ran for governor of the southern state of Georgia in 2018. No matter where you are at on the political spectrum, voting is the premier founding tenet of our democracy and has been under attack since many Americans earned the right to vote. So if you have questions about voting, the history of voter suppression, and how to make our elections safe and fair for everyone, I recommend you read this book for yourself. That is Our Time Is Now by Stacey Abrams. My next pick is a Southern Gothic thriller called The Wife Upstairs. It is one of the most anticipated thrillers of 2021, so make sure you get your hands on this one. It's a great read for fans of Megan Miranda, Taryn Fisher, and Lisa Jewell. So the main character, Jane, is a broke dog walker who just moved to Birmingham, Alabama. Her luck turns when she meets Eddie Rochester, a mysterious resident in the wealthy neighborhood where she walks dogs. Mysterious as in his wife drowned in a boating accident. He's rich, charming, and handsome, but as they fall for one another, Jane is haunted by the legend of his first wife. So this Southern Gothic twist is about an ill-advised attraction and some domestic suspense. That's The Wife Upstairs by Rachel Hawkins. My final recommendation comes out on January 12th, and that is The Yellow Wife by Sadika Johnson. And this book also, I think, is a little heavy, and I promise to choose more books written by Black authors that experience joy in the future. But if you are trying to read more historical fiction or works by authors of color in the new year, I recommend this book. So, born on a plantation in Virginia, Phoebe Brown was promised her freedom on her 18th birthday. But when her 18th birthday finally arrives, she finds herself thrust into an infamous slave jail called Devil's Half Acre. This book is about Phoebe's fight and barter for her own freedom. There's some love involved on the outside of the jail, and it's a heart-pounding page-turner for those who enjoy historical fiction. This book has been compared to 12 Years a Slave, if you read that or saw the movie, and I hope you enjoy Yellow Wife by Sadika Johnson. And those are my five brand new picks from the Agnes Robinson Waterloo Public Library in January 2021. I would love to hear what your first reads of the new year are if you want to comment below. And as always, if you have any suggestions for books you want the library to purchase, please let us know and we would be happy to get some more reading material into your hands. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you all stay safe, and I will see you next month for five more recommendations.